All right, thank you. We are celebrating all things French as we look forward to the French Open coming up this Sunday. And what better way to celebrate than with some French cuisine?
Joining us now, the best French food I have ever tasted in my life, Chef Laurie Erickson. Bonjour.
Bonjour, monsieur. Bonjour, madame.
That's about all we know.
I know, me too.
Au revoir.
Wait. This is really cool because the French Open is coming up and a lot of people want to, you know, sit around the TV, maybe watching it, mm-hmm. but they want to kind of get into that French
experience.
And you've been to France, you know all about the Eiffel Tower and all the cheeses
all
and everything.
Yeah. Speaking of cheese, uh-huh. the French love their cheese, absolutely love their cheese. And so you want to do a cheese platter mm-hmm. if your friends are coming over to watch the French Open. And, you know, you can take a couple of pieces of cheese and stick it on a platter with some crackers and that's okay.
Uh-huh.
But let's just, you know, let's embellish here. So typically for a basic cheese tray, you need a fresh cheese. This is a Boursin. This is an aged, what we call kind of a stinky cheese. Uh-huh. this is a Camembert. And then we've got a hard cheese, which is a Gruyere, mm-hmm. and some type of blue cheese. This is Roquefort, or you can get Gorgonzola.
So you got a lot of varieties, but you've I noticed you got a nice leaf underneath.
I know. Well, a lot of these things I pick from my garden, which is really kind of fun. And these are just fig leaves. There's a lot of fig trees around here.
Why are the French cheese? Because I was like, is that blue cheese? And you said, oh, no, no.
It's Roquefort.
Why are the French cheeses better?
Honestly, it's in the milk. The milk is so far superior to any milk that you can get here in America. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're eating grass, they're out having fun, and they're just eating acorns and all this yummy stuff that makes their milk taste good.
Even the organic milk that we can purchase, it's much better.
Is it just
got much better fat in it and just better taste?
It's just what they're eating, and they're calm, and they're not crammed in pens, and, you know, that's a whole other story for another day. But, you know, the French love their cheese, love their cows, love their sheep. So let's embellish this, okay? Maybe a couple kinds of crackers. These are good. These are awesome little fig crackers.
Oh, are these French crackers?
Those are so good.
You just start building from there. So then we're going to add maybe some jam.
Nice.
Of course, it's homemade jam. Maybe
some olives. And you actually made that. That's homemade.
You don't have to make
jam.
I mean, this is just a mason jar. You can put some jam in there if you want to. Yeah. Add a little salami or salumi, however you want to call it. Some nuts, of course. So all these little things, you know, a lot of it you can find in your pantry right now. I mean, a lot of us have some maybe dried fruit. So I'm going to put some, let's see, where should I put it? Some apricots right there. All like, you know, lots of good colors, some fresh figs.
Are there any rules when you're composing your tray?
No, that's what I meant, you know, just a hard cheese, a soft cheese, a fresh cheese.
And then
different kinds. And then that's it. And just add, build.
Thank you, President. This is a really gorgeous presentation on this cutting board. This cutting board, by the way, looks like it's an Italian cutting board as well, but you've got a French preparation on this. Why is presentation so important?
Oh, because it shows you care. Uh-huh. I mean, you know, you could put cheese, like I said, cheese on a board with some crackers, but you know, it shows that you care. You take the time to make it pretty, to present it nice to people.
It
kind of makes you feel special.
Oh, absolutely.
Right? All right, strawberries. I mean, I could keep going. Some rosemary. Uh-huh. I mean, you can go as crazy as you want to, but really, how long did that take? No time at all.
Yeah, just a couple of minutes.
And most of this is from
the
garden.
I'm shocked at how quickly you did that,
What are the other things that we have here? Because, I mean, all of this comes from, basically, I understand, the same pastry that
we're going to make now. We're going to do a baked brie, and this is so easy. This is just buy this in the store.
It.
Now, we're going to get this puff pastry you can buy. There's a bunch of different kinds. I prefer the all butter kind, but this you just kind of pick it up. I mean, two ingredients. Wrap it around like this.
Uh-huh.
Yep. Set it back down on the parchment paper. This keeps it from sticking. You know how much I love my parchment paper.
Oh, yeah.
Now we brush it with a little glue, which is just egg whites. And a little bit of water. Okay, that's the glue. Then I took another sheet of that and I just kind of cut some little shapes of leaves. You don't have to do that.
This is the part you probably can't do at home.
You can't.
Mine would not look like that.
These are the vines, and then you slowly put the leaves on.
To make those leaves, or did you just cut
You can use a cookie cutter. Uh-huh.
Did you freehand those?
Yes, I did.
Look at that.
You can do, you know, stars, hearts, moons, round things. And look at this. All this, it's just looks so beautiful, right?
That is so impressive.
So we have one. We have one
now,
that's
of course,
ready.
Because we can't bake that one now, because how long do you usually bake that?
It's going to take about, I would say, 40 minutes.
Okay.
And the thing is, you've got to get it out of the oven just in time. Some little berries. Hang on, I'm going to finish.
I imagine as soon as you take it out, it's ready to serve.
It's ready to serve.
Yeah.
And the good news is that it's got to be nice and warm. So
okay,
I'm going to
so you've got that
I was going to add the magic of TV. Do we have one?
I know, we do.
Yes, we got one
right here.
Oh my,
so
wow.
Look at how, after it's baked, look how beautiful that looks. It puffs up beautifully. And that's the great thing with this dough. You can make, I made these palmiers with the dough. I made the cheese straws with this dough.
Everything on the spread you have made.
Yes.
We know you were busy all weekend long.
So we slide this on here. Look how beautiful that is.
Wow.
Now, there's a money shot right here. Hopefully it's gonna be ready.
Yeah, wait. We cut it. Let's get the close-up. There you go.
Watch the cheese coming out of here.
Cut a big hole in it, and then all this yummy cheese.
Ooh. Oh my gosh. Ooh.
Now I just want to get a cracker right now.
Melissa's over there.
Melissa's ooing and eyeing.
Get a cracker, scoop it up, but wait.
Oh yeah.
I think we're going to embellish it a little bit more.
No.
A little drizzle of honey.
Mother Nature's sweetener.
That is a fun honey dispenser.
Isn't that cool?
I like that.
So get the little sweet, the little salty. You want to try it?
Oh,
yes.
Heck yeah, all day.
Do you need to ask?
I know.
Yeah.
There you go.
And I understand you're going to be with a bunch of people at the opening of Spoleto behind the Custom House Friday night.
Yes, I think I'll do a cheese platter there.
Going to do a cheese platter there. So, you know,
you say that, and I was going to look for you and stop by.
I know, we'll have some candles.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We would have candles here, but we're not allowed to have them.
See, I would get a little jam, a little bit of strawberry, maybe a fig, put it on there, break this off, use this as a scoop. Thank you very much.
Absolutely. Be sure to catch the French Open on the Tennis Channel. That's the Tennis Channel. It kicks off May the 26th. And runs through June the 9th. Chef Laurie Erickson, always a pleasure. She is the number one personal chef here in Charleston. She does travel. Chef Laurie Erickson, Chef Laurie at chef.com.
All right.
Thanks, guys.
Au revoir. We are back with more Low Country Live right after this.